Previously on Lost.
Greetings, Ron Smalik.
And Fellonius the Wizard. We are starting season 4 preview on Lost.
The beginning of the end.
Oh, sort of, yeah.
The end of the beginning.
But you had something else to discuss before that, and didn't you have any answers on your video as well?
Oh, I do. I'm going to rip this Band-Aid off. So in between season 3 and 4, 10 years ago, a little computer game came out called Lost Via Domus.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure at the time it had something groundbreaking in it. It looked pretty good, visually. The visuals were okay.
Yeah.
So I bought it, and I played it. And for whatever reason, even though I feel like I'm a really big Lost fan, I never played it till now.
No.
And by the end of the second hour, well, actually quite a bit before that, I was like, wow, this is terrible. So, I don't even think I want to continue playing it, but I will if people want to see it. And
you have up a couple of videos from it, right?
Yeah, I put up two. I'm really curious what happens, but I may just read a wiki or something, because what I'll say is, so what I wanted out of the game, I had really low expectations because I know it had a really low Metacritic rating.
Yep.
My hope was that I would get to see a lot of the island locations.
Oh yeah.
And that I would get to interact with the characters, from the show, and they would feel like the characters.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't need to interact with them a lot. I just wanted to, see Hurley and hear some jokes, see Sawyer.
Yeah, you did meet Kate, that I know.
Yeah. You meet pretty much everybody at the plane crash.
No.
And it looks okay. I mean, for its time, it probably looks really good. So I won't say that.
2007, 2008, that's true.
I will say that the game designers put every possible mechanic they could think of into this game. There's some kind of cool ideas. There's a part where you... the whole plot... Okay, here's how... This is telling, right? So the initial thing, the initial plot is you wake up and you don't know who you are or how you got there. Sound familiar?
Haven't heard that before, no.
No, not every Minecraft map ever. So that was a problem. Now, the good part is you're a photographer, and so you got to find your camera, and then you...
That's a cool thing.
Yeah, and then the main mechanic is that you have a flashback. You're trying to remember things, and the way you do it is in your flashback, you take a photograph, and you have to zoom in and focus and get the right thing in frame. So it's kind of like Pokemon Snap.
Okay.
Which sounds really cool, right?
Yep.
So then there's all these other cool mechanics. There's a part where you have to chase a dog and keep up with him.
No kidding.
So, kind of a unique sort of quest.
Done that in Harry Potter several times, yes.
Yeah, there's going through caves with a torch, and you have to manage... that it doesn't go out when you go through a waterfall, or you have to put it out on purpose. There's some nice logic puzzles conceptually.
Yeah.
But the way that all of these, so there's a lot of good mechanics, but the way they're all implemented is so horrible. The dialogue, for example, you walk up to a character and there's three tabs, and each tab has four different things you can say.
Okay, that's a lot.
And none of them really seem to fit what I would want to say to a person.
Okay, so the role-playing bit is not that good, okay?
Yeah, and when you select one, it's not like a dialogue tree. You just always have the same possible responses until you pick the correct one to move the story forward.
Okay,
yeah. Yeah, and I feel sometimes their responses are not in character. Kate made no sense to me whatsoever.
Nope.
Even more
I
than
I must say, that really put me off and said, okay, I can watch this later.
Yeah. Now, I will say there's also some cool things, like you can get sucked into the jet engine on the beach.
Ooh,
that was fun.
Nice.
Okay, so I will stop with the negative stuff, but basically, I'm glad that I got it. It's going to go on my shelf with my DVDs, but it just... It's like they have non-game designers just throwing in every feature they can think of, and I appreciate a lot of what's in there, but at the same time, the logic puzzles work too easy. And
still, we know that many of the series shows writers were helping them. It was Ubisoft, right?
Yeah, I don't know how. I don't know how much the writers. I think
they
gave guidelines.
They tried to help them somewhat, give them a story or something like that.
My guess, and I'm totally speculating, is that it was kind of a one-way street. Like, they gave them a bunch of guidelines that said, don't talk about this, don't talk about that.
Okay.
And here's
instead, all right.
Yeah, and here's some stuff you could do that might be cool, but I don't think they reviewed the overall story or in-game because, no.
it's tough to do as well, of course.
Yeah.
But still, if you are a big Lost fan, you shouldn't be worried about it that much.
No. It as far as I know, it doesn't introduce anything new, and the character that you play has no references in the show, so it's...
Okay, but the environment then, are you really going around in a jungle and suddenly it's raining?
Yeah.
Well, that's cool enough.
I mean, the caves part, like, I feel like there's more caves in the game than on the show.
Okay.
And the black smoke monster, I didn't really like, oh gosh, okay, I'm not going to be negative. So basically, I played it, you can watch my first two episodes, I really struggled to try and make it funny and also not be like, what is this garbage? But okay, so that's Viadomus. I don't think I'm going to continue that unless somebody really goes in there and says, I really, really want to see it. So we'll see.
Perhaps you should play it and nobody else has to.
Yeah, I don't even think I'm going to play it offline. That's the thing. Okay, so on a positive note, some YouTube comments from my last episodes.
Nice.
Two new commenters. I really appreciate Leshka Schket and Krin9. Both
right.
Just
welcome,
say hi.
Guys.
And then Thungon put a lot of thought into his responses to our season three, the last couple episodes. It was always nice to read where he agrees with us and where where he feels like he likes certain things that we didn't like.
Yeah, just, but that's how we humans are.
Yeah, exactly. Not that either of us are wrong or right, but just like it appeals to certain...
Yes. And that really shows us also how wide this show is actually bringing it. It's not just some nerds loving this, two or three nerds. This is for many more people.
Yeah. So we need to get in season four because I hope we're not going to go super long like we did last time, but... I watched these three episodes. We have season four, episode 1, 2, and 3.
Yep.
We have the beginning of the end, confirmed dead, and The Economist.
Yep.
And my summary of these are kind of slow, the first one, tense, the second one, and weird, the third one.
Well, that was... surprising.
Good.
Okay. Well, I'm disappointed, and really disappointed.
Really? Oh, yeah. No.
So,
okay.
I think I can expect it.
Let me just say, I was super curious what your reaction would be because, you know, they're introducing some new characters. They're playing around with the flash forwards.
Yeah.
And... myself, having already met these characters, I knew what to expect, but I wasn't sure how they would come off for you. So let's get into episode one. Would you?
Yep.
What does the DVD summary tell us about this episode?
Let's see. The survivors argue about whether the freighter folk are who they claim to be, and split into two camps. Locke's group, who feel they are coming to kill them all, and Jack's group, who feels rescue is close at hand. In a flash forward, Hurley receives a visit from an old friend and goes back into the mental institution.
Oh, now I know why you don't like this one.
Well, I thought we should see the freighter folk, and we didn't. And that was most disappointing, because I wanted to see that big army coming through the jungle.
Oh, well, you do see at least one freighter folk in this one.
Yeah, but that's not an army.
No, it isn't an army. There's,
do you understand my disappointment now? I thought there will be a whole tanker full of them.
Oh, I'll spoil it for you. There's not an army.
I have already.
Oh, wait a minute. Okay, I'll spoil it for you. There's not an army on the freighter.
Either. Okay. Three idiots and a pilot, but that's the next episode. So, Hurley, the flash forward didn't give me anything.
It actually gave me some stuff that is important to the marketing for this season. Now, so let's do the flash forward. So Hurley's in a red Mustang. Jack is drinking. Jack sees it on TV.
Yep.
Hurley crashes, run from the cop. And he starts yelling out, "I'm one of the Oceanic Six. I'm one of the Oceanic Six." Now, that's very important. That is
something important.
Yes, yes.
That's the first thing I have written on my notes. Oceanic Six.
Yep. Who are they? So, Kate, Jack, and Hurley, probably.
Yes. And we know later on, we know one more.
Yeah.
But now, we'll take these three first.
Yeah. Now, that's assuming, by the way, So that's assuming that only six people got off the island publicly.
Or these six came back to the States.
Yeah, and there might have been others that got off, but they weren't publicly part of the six. Now, exactly. There's probably someone in the coffin, which would be a fourth person.
Yeah.
It's probably not Jack's dad. I don't know why I just thought of that now, but anyway.
You are just keeping on, because he always says previously on Lost.
Yeah, yeah. We see Hurley. I'm going to jump around a little bit. We see Hurley deny knowing Anna Lucia.
Yep.
That was kind of interesting. So they're definitely lying about something.
Well, in this case, we get back to Hurley denying stuff. Mm-hmm. He just wants one thing. And when he suddenly, "I can put you back on the mental institution, you know that." Mm-hmm. "Did you do that?" He was so happy. "Yes, I want back to the loony bin. I want to go back to the loony bin." Because he was afraid that they would put him in prison, in jail.
Well,
and if he says anything about Anna Lucia, he has to tell about the whole thing.
I got the impression that the reason he wants to go back is because he wants to take the medicine and forget what happened.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, he...
That didn't work well.
He gets a visitor.
Jack?
No.
No, first one he gets. The first one.
Yeah.
Who claims to be from the airplane. Company.
Yeah.
Oceanic.
Oh, sorry. Oh, yeah. He has three visitors then. So first, the ghost of future past, Matthew Abaddon. And I really like this actor.
Okay.
He, I think he's very mysterious looking. I'll just say that. And he's also on Fringe, which I was watching, I think, at the same time. Or no, might I wasn't. Be,
but he's also a liar.
Yeah, so he offers to upgrade Hurley to a new facility, and Hurley starts getting suspicious, and then finally Matthew Abaddon senses that he's not going to get anywhere, and he says, "Are they still alive?"
Yeah.
So I interpreted that as whoever he works for doesn't know how to find the island, and that they suspect that some people got left behind. And So then we have the second visitor, which is the ghost of future past. Or, well, this was the ghost of the future. Charlie's the ghost of the past.
Yeah.
And that, what did you think about Charlie showing up?
Well, I wished, of course, that I would never see him again. But I said the same about Shannon, and that hasn't been correct still. The way they made Charlie behave in this situation was way more self-assured and really knowing stuff, mm-hmm. which really meant that it wasn't the real Charlie.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Sort of. It felt like, otherwise, Charlie as dead has got more knowledge than he had as alive, which didn't don't say much, actually, because he didn't have any knowledge. Mm-hmm. But now, suddenly, he was knowing more about how it really works around the island and stuff.
Hmm.
And it feels like he has connected with the island, the character we call the island, but that can't be. Mm-hmm. So it's a vision. And actually, Hurley makes him go away.
Yeah, I thought that was interesting that Hurley believes in himself, I think.
Yeah.
Enough that he can dispel these visions now. Because when we saw him with Dave, obviously he couldn't do that. So.
No.
And then we get the ghost of the present, which is Jack.
Yep.
And this scene made me feel really sad. Because
you did? Now, first of all, let's put it in chronological order here, if we are able. Is it before or after the last fast flash forward we had with Jack, when he was drinking even more, chasing Kate, and was very bearded?
This is before.
Is it before?
Yeah, because the last thing Jack says to Hurley is, "We're never going back." And in with Kate, he's like, "We have to go back." He's very distraught.
Okay.
So something happens in between now and then. Yep.
These fast forwards are really difficult to claim because I will call them not fast forwards. They are present time, but they are not presented as present time. And that means that the island is now the past.
Yeah, I agree, but I think it would be easier for us to say that the island is present and these are forward. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because that's what everyone else does. well, the thing...
Don't say that to me, because then I really want to keep it the other way around. I do the opposite.
Yeah, the thing about this is I don't think Jack goes to see Hurley. He goes to make sure Hurley's going to keep quiet.
Yeah, about what?
About whatever, yeah. And
and I suspect the first guy from Oceanic, where she wasn't, is also trying to make Hurley talk or not talk.
I thought it was...
We have Charlie. Charlie wanted him to get back, right?
I don't remember Charlie having a point. I thought he got disbelieved before he actually... He only convinced... Well, he basically said, "I'm dead, but I'm also here."
Yeah.
And it made me think, like, okay, if you die off the island, you can appear on the island. If you die on the island, you can appear outside the island, kind of thing. Yeah. I'm not sure, but...
Well, we'll get more of that later on, and alas, we're also going to see Charlie.
Yeah.
But let's get back to Jack. They are in a basketball, well, somewhere in a gym court somewhere. Yeah.
In the mental center, yeah.
Yeah. And Jack is actually trying to be the good guy, the nice guy, the friendly guy, but Hurley sees right through him.
I think so, and that's why I'm sad.
Yeah, sort of. But on the other hand, I have never said that Jack is a good hero. So in my case, Hurley is better hero than Jack.
Yeah. Now, Hurley says, and I'm going to ask this question in the context of what we've seen in these all three of these episodes. So Hurley said that he's sorry he went with Locke.
Yeah.
So Hurley being the hero, as you said, implies that Locke was wrong about the freighter and he should have gone with Jack because Hurley went with the group with Locke.
Yeah.
So that's interesting to me.
Sort of, yes, but that we need more talk about that one later on.
Okay.
But for me, it's like something happened on the island between Hurlis and Jax and the freighter gang.
Mm-hmm.
That meant that Locke wasn't wrong as such. We know for a fact that Locke wasn't wrong, but something happened, and I could only call it civil war. That's what I'm guessing.
I'm not sure that Locke was right or wrong. Oh, we'll get into that. But basically, I need to know, why does Hurley say he's sorry he went with Locke, and what changes Jack's mind that he wants to go back? That's what I got from this flash forward.
Yeah.
Okay.
From the flash forward, there wasn't even nothing more. No, not directly.
Mm-mm.
I must say, it feels also like Hurley's got more social abilities, and even he's much more intelligent.
Mm-hmm.
And he's making those hoop shots like I wouldn't do them even if I trained for a whole week, but he just throws them away. And yeah,
I wasn't sure if that was a commentary on his luck, not having bad luck anymore.
Might be. And I have never heard of playing horse, so that was a new one.
Oh, that's
that one.
Do you know the rules, or do you want me to?
We had something similar, but then we had to make shoot a soccer ball towards a wall, and if you missed, you got one of those letters.
Yeah.
Not horse, but another
pig.
Word.
We used to have pig.
Yeah, play pig. No, yeah, why not? We have four grease. Well. Nevertheless, let's get back to
the present.
Okay, the island. I was supposed to say.
Yeah.
Where do we start?
Well, I think chronological is best. They are. So the group is basically, I think, at the radio tower. Most all of them, I think. The people on the beach. I can't remember if they met up or not yet. I watched this a couple days ago, but
yeah.
Jack tells Kate that he's going to kill Locke.
Yep, if he shows up, yeah.
Yep. Ben tells Danielle to take Alex and run.
Yeah.
And then Hurley, I forgot who he's talking to, but he thinks that when he gets off the island, that all the money will be gone. Because they think he's dead, and so he's going to be free.
Yeah, that's true.
Which, the fact that he had... Well, okay, it actually doesn't really matter yet. So then Desmond comes back to the beach. He tells them about Charlie and not Penny's boat.
Yep.
And Hurley and Saeed decide they don't want to radio that information to Jack because of fear of communication monitoring.
Yeah.
This is the one time I feel like they were actually justified for not sharing information.
Yeah.
And just
stop. And Hurley just throws the walkie-talkie out in the sea.
Oh, yeah, that was nice. Yeah, he's really starting to, like...
That's what I'm meaning. He's taking charge here and there.
Yeah.
He's since he drove that van through the enemies, I thought that, what? He's growing. On the other camp, the Jack's camp, Naomi's gone.
Yep, she went west.
That really pissed me off. Well, I'm not saying that it's impossible, but why would you try to run away with a knife in your back?
I mean, I was surprised if a knife could kill you that quickly, but, I mean, we have seen a lot of people on the island heal very quickly, right?
Yeah. We have seen that, but Naomi's probably not one of those who would get any benefits from the island.
Yeah, I mean, basically, Jack, Ben, and Danielle are going to go after Naomi, and Kate's going to take the people to the beach, supposedly.
Yeah. Supposedly, yeah.
Hurley falls behind, and he hears whispers, and then sees the cabin.
Yeah. Jacob's house.
But it seems like the cabin's not in the same place that Locke saw it.
Nope, that's true.
Which is weird.
Yeah.
So the cabin could apparently move around.
Yes, it actually, Hurley sees it at two places.
Yeah.
And he just do his thing, count to 10, and it's gone.
So does that mean that Hurley is getting a connection to the island?
He could have, mainly because Hurley is one of the nice guys that could believe the island if the island was able to speak to him.
Yeah.
But on the other hand, he's more down to earth as well.
Yeah, sorry, I'm putting a jacket on. When I first saw this, like, I wasn't even speculating at all about this. It just happened. But definitely now I'm like, oh, so the island is trying to, or Jacob or something is trying to get Hurley to on its side now, finally. Yeah. So, well, Kate took, just interrupt me whenever, Kate took Jack's phone, and she's following the correct trail. Jack and them are following the wrong trail.
Yeah.
Some of this I felt like it was, like I said, this one was a little slow. It was just taking too long.
Yeah.
Now, Naomi changes the tracking signal and makes it look like she lies for them.
Yeah.
But she dies, for real, I think.
Yep.
And she says, tell my sister that I love her. And I was like, oh, who's her sister? Okay, this is going to get interesting.
I was actually thinking the same thing. Oh, dear. It might be someone we have already met.
Yeah.
Ana Lucia. Yay!
And then, oh, Hurley actually looks in the cabin. He sees a guy in the rocking chair.
Yep.
And then he sees an eye, which, was it Locke's eye?
Yep, I think it was Locke.
Okay.
Here we have a meeting that we will never know anything about later on.
I don't think it was Locke, though, because later on, Locke was surprised that Hurley saw the cabin. And
do you mean like that? Okay.
But like Locke did show up right away.
Locke was on his way to Jacob, wasn't he?
Yeah, that part was actually confusing. But then
would he otherwise go around alone?
I don't know.
Well, never mind. He's on his way back anyway.
Yep. Now everybody meets up. Locke says that he needs to talk Jack down.
Yeah. You know,
too late pretty much at this point.
Yep.
It was kind of sad when Hurley tells Claire about Charlie.
Yep. It went fast. He is dead. So
yep. Jack punches John, and he actually tries to shoot him, pulls the trigger, but the gun's not loaded again.
Yes.
So that was interesting. If I'm ever like in a stressful situation where there's people with guns, I'm just going to carry empty guns so that when people take it away from me, I can surprise them.
Yeah, but it's always a revolver and you can see if there's any bullets in them.
Yeah.
Why don't they look? I mean, they're standing there with the revolver in front of them and they can't just see, uh-oh, no bullets.
Yeah.
I mean, come on. Even I can do that. I have never held a revolver.
Yeah,
it's difference between pistols because you have a magazine in that one.
Yeah, well, everybody who's holding a gun in this series seems to know how to quickly eject a magazine and check it. So
yep.
So then I give John credit for actually saying like we're going to go live at the barracks. That's a good idea.
Yep.
And the group basically splits up. Half go with John and half go with Jack.
Yep.
And like we said, Hurley goes with John and Jack and Kate go a different way, which is like, okay, we know that somehow Jack and Hurley end up together. So this whole season, I remember like tracking who are the Oceanic Six and are they together or split up?
Yeah.
And they keep splitting up in different ways. And it's like, will they, won't they, when are they going to escape? Like,
yeah.
And then finally at the end, we have the helicopter drop. Another helicopter drops a parachute guy, and it's a skinny guy with a tie.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I went through that quick, so what did I miss?
I don't know. But there's one thing that I felt also was disappointing for me. It was the mystic, the mystery, the magic is gone. I mean, it doesn't feel like the Jax group is actually trying to get off the island anymore, and it doesn't feel like John is actually moving about doing the island's work anymore. And the island, well, Jacob and his cottage once, but otherwise there's not that much. It's more about logistics and who is going to shoot who and with what and stuff. It really doesn't, it feels like some old Western. It's not the Lost that we saw in the first season.
Yeah, it was about reminding us where everybody is, tying up a few little loose ends and getting ready for the real episodes, I think.
That's a good thing to say.
Yeah. That's what I noticed too. Like, I just watched the Game of Thrones season 6 premiere, and it's the same thing. It's like 5 minutes after the cliffhanger, you know, how do all those little things wrap up? But you don't really get new story per se.
Okay. Well, it's a popular series I haven't seen once.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to do it either, so don't try.
Okay. but the next episode, we get actually quite a lot of new information, I think.
Yeah, sort of. Let's go. I'll read the back of the DVDs. Wonderful. Episode 2, Confirmed Dead. Let's have some more light on my place. The footage of the wreckage of Oceanic Flight 815 plays on a news report, and through flashbacks, the four new freighter folk are introduced. Yeah. On the island, the survivors continue to question the intentions of their supposed rescuers. Locke takes one hostage, yeah, sort of, and Jack and Kate help locate the rest. Well, the actions on the island, well, they were okay.
Yeah, we could probably do the flashbacks pretty quick.
No, I think we should take one character at a time. Let's talk about that. What was he? Physiologist or whatever?
Oh, Daniel Faraday is a physicist.
Yeah.
So let's start with his flashback, though, and then jump to the island. So we see, actually, context is some time ago, I don't know when, maybe like around day 40 or something.
Might be.
A submarine is underwater. It finds a plane, and they say that it's 8:15 in the Indian Ocean.
Yeah.
And they start showing camera footage of the dead bodies, but they can't bring them up.
No, it's 5,000 feet down or something like that.
Yeah. So as far as the world is concerned, they have confirmed everyone on the plane died.
Yeah, but we are not seeing more than one person, but still.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then you see, throughout this episode, you see different flashbacks of the new characters, which is interesting that, I mean, usually we don't get flashbacks for the new people right away, but we see Dan, because we're going to talk about him. So he's watching this show, and he is moved to start crying.
Yeah.
And he doesn't know why.
Probably because it's wrong. He's some sort of connection with the place where the real ones are, something like that.
Yeah.
We'll see about that later on.
So then, now come to current day, and he parachuted from the chopper, and he has a gun with him.
On the back, trying to hide it, yes.
Yeah, and the first thing that he says is, I'm here to rescue you, which I think is a Star Wars reference.
Yes. Is it Luke Skywalker in the jails? Yes.
Yep, and he's lost his pack and his phone.
Yeah.
He says that there were four people on the chopper, the pilot plus three.
Yeah.
I think, Dan, are we going through his whole arc?
Well, more or less.
Okay.
Because...
So he meets Jack and...
Yeah.
Jack's group, I should say.
Yes.
And...
But there aren't many of them. It's just Jack and Kate, right?
It should be their whole group, shouldn't it? I can't remember now.
Well, nevertheless.
And then I think
the rest is sent towards the beach.
Yes. Oh, that's right. Why did Jack and Kate go off separate?
I think they were trying to chase. They were standing in the rain at one of the fuselage bits, and suddenly they heard that it wasn't thunder, it was something else. Yeah,
that's right.
The helicopter. So they went out and find that guy.
That's right.
And with that guy, Dan's help, and the telephone they have, they find the next one.
Here
we have a full-blown idiot, and I suspect that everybody loved this man.
Well, first they find a box with gas with, like, biohazard symbols on it.
Yeah.
And gas masks, which is ominous.
Yeah.
Now, let's talk about Dan first before we to the next person. So, He's not the army you were expecting.
Nope.
He says he's a physicist. He looks pretty harmless to me, like a geek. I had the impression that this guy might be their leader, and he's play-acting, that he's timid. That's just my feeling at this point.
It wasn't my feeling at all. He's not interested in being anyone's leader at the moment. He is there because there is some anomalies that he wants to be investigating. I mean, he really didn't bother that day he lost his own gun, even.
Yeah, but so if this freighter is supposed to be people coming... Well, okay, so he does, right before we find Miles, he does admit that rescuing them is not the primary objective.
Exactly.
But he doesn't say what their objective is, though.
No, because, well, they don't get any time to talk more about it, so there is a reason.
So then, like you said, next we find Miles Strom.
Yeah.
And Miles' flashback is...
It's very interesting.
Well, he didn't see the footage. He was listening to it on the radio.
Yep.
And he's a ghost whisperer, basically.
Yes.
Now, do you think he's legit?
Oh, dear. We are going to go that way. Yes, he's legit.
I think so, too. I remember being suspicious, but I think he can talk to a ghost, and I think he... In the past, he would do it to try to, like, gain something from it. Like, either make a buck, mercenary-like, or, like, but the ghost that he chose might have hidden treasure kind of thing. Sort of.
Might have been a robber who has hidden his stash or something like that.
Yeah.
And he really needs to get that one.
Now, Miles knows... Or Miles immediately accuses them of killing Naomi because Naomi, when she said, tell my sister I love her, that was a code phrase.
Yes.
So now, after finally all this time, I realize, okay, Naomi was a bad guy.
Yeah.
And.
Sort of.
Yeah. So. And then they find Naomi's body, and Miles, like, talks to the ghost and confirms what really happened.
Kate told him what was the real deal, and he says that's how it is. But there is one thing that happens that really make me feel like he's not totally villain, and that is when he is in the flashback, he is actually asking for $200 to do this ghost thing. And then he finds the stash, a lot of money, and then he suddenly says, it was easier than I thought, you get a refund, and gives $100 back to the old lady.
Yeah.
That's a nice gesture. You can't really beat that one. He didn't need to do it. Of course, he has already earned, like, I don't know how much money he found up there, but he didn't have to do that.
Yeah.
And I like that, because that makes that guy more believable.
I was surprised, because I don't remember him being a strong character at all. I actually don't really remember what his point is beyond speaking to Naomi. But he came off as very strong, giving orders, not putting up with any crap.
Nope.
Certainly more in charge than Daniel Faraday. Yeah. So,
but he needs to have the group assembled. That's important.
Yeah, and I mean, obviously, so we've been figuring out, like, okay, the island has some sort of electromagnetic properties. That's Daniel. Yeah. The island has this thing where dead come back to life. That's Miles. So yes, these people are all specialists in something that have been sent here. And so far they seem more like scientists than an army.
Yeah, exactly.
So then we get, the next person we get introduced to is Lapidus, Frank Lapidus,
yep,
who is the pilot of the helicopter.
Yep.
I really like this guy.
Absolutely. Totally agree. That was the only one who suddenly made sense anyway. And he was so cool and laid back.
Yeah.
Still, he was totally wiped out and unconscious and all that. And then they said, where is the wreck of the helicopter? What?
He's like, oh, yeah, I didn't wreck it. What kind of pilot do you think I am?
Yeah, I like that one. Oh, dear, that was the best part of the whole thing.
Now,
like, what do you think? Who do you think I am?
Yeah, now this is interesting because in his flashback, he's watching the footage. Yes. And he doesn't cry, I don't think.
No?
No, only Daniel cried. Sorry.
He's more or less angry.
He sees the footage of the pilot, the dead body, and he realizes there's no wedding ring. Yes. And he says he was supposed to be the pilot on that flight, but he called in sick that day.
Yeah.
So now I got to ask, did the island purposely keep him? So up till now, we've seen everybody get drawn to the island. Did the island keep him away so that it could bring him back later to help it, or to keep him away because he's not good for the island kind of thing?
No, I don't think the pilots, neither one of them, had something to do with the island as such.
Okay.
Not so far, because then they have tried to save at least one of them.
Yeah.
There was always a co-pilot as well, and both pilots were dead.
And I'm sort of projecting what I want to happen, not spoiling anything, just saying, like, okay, here's this new guy. Oh, this is the first person that I've seen that was stopped from going to the island.
Yeah. And then,
yeah,
well, sort of. But it also makes him an expert as such on the Oceanic 815.
But yes,
that's not what the group is gathered for. It doesn't feel like that. It feels like this guy can fly anything through anything, and they need a good, really good pilot. And it seems like it's more of a, well, some sort of, I don't know.
Yeah, like he knows that Juliet wasn't on the plane. Like he apparently memorized the passenger list, which I don't think the pilot typically would do that.
No, but since he couldn't see his own mate sitting in the pilot seat, why would he believe anyone else?
Yeah.
And it also feels like, okay, of course, that plane has been down there, but they could have drowned anyone. Mm-hmm. I didn't get the feeling of that being the plane of Oceanic 815. It wasn't broken at any part. It wasn't in any piece at all. It more feels like they had just put down an old wreck down there.
Yeah, I agree. Like, I think it's supposed to make us, the audience, question if they're alive or dead. But to me, it doesn't feel right. Yeah, I mean, they're alive.
You know, if you are trying to dive into water yourself, it is hard. Water is not soft.
Yeah.
No way it's called soft. And if you're just trying to crash land an aircraft into water, it will break somehow. This was totally, it laid straight like an arrow. All wings were at the right place. No, doesn't feel right at all. It feels like they had put it on top of the surface and then it just bubbled down.
Yeah, now there's two possibilities that come to my mind. One is that Ben arranged for the plane to be there so people wouldn't look for the Oceanic 815.
No.
Is somebody else that we don't know who it is yet.
or more likely. And it's probably the people who say they are from the Oceanic company, but probably they are someone else. And now we are getting even more strange groups here.
Yeah, so
Ben can't do that because Ben was surprised when he saw that plane crash and get into pieces over his island.
But he could do it afterwards, though. He could, right then, he sends off Goodwin and Ethan, and then he goes back, he makes some calls, and he sets in motion, like, the dummy plane.
And he needs dead bodies as well.
Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, like, yeah, I wouldn't put it past.
It's a possibility, yes. Yeah. No, when it comes to Ben, we don't get anything past him.
Yeah, the problem is right now, we don't... So let's say if we were given the answer, it wouldn't mean anything. Like, there's no consequence to why somebody would fake it. We need to find out why they faked it, and then we'll find out who faked it. Because right now, it's just interesting trivia.
Yeah. Okay, before we find Frank, we also get a power struggle. As we know, Miles and Frank do have the guns. Mm-hmm. And thanks to Desmond and some others, they are getting their guns lost. So suddenly it's Jack who's back with the gun.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not totally sure how many of them follows back to Frank, but Frank is getting a flare up at least.
Yeah. Well, let's do some more characters, mm-hmm. and then we'll cover the group, right?
Yeah.
So we see Matthew Abaddon, the black guy who visited Hurley.
Oh, yep.
Sorry. One more quick diversion. When Hurley is outside talking to Charlie in front of the mental hospital, and he's sitting by the tree, remember back in season one when Professor Snape sent us a nice email and a picture of himself by a tree? That's where he took that picture.
Yes, I recognized it.
Yeah, so makes me jealous.
Thanks a lot, Prof.
So I was waiting to see if you recognized it. Okay, so Abaddon hires Naomi to take four specialists on a covert op.
And thereby making Naomi the leader.
Yeah, and she's like the fighter who's going to protect these four. Four. And then she says, what if there are survivors? So they know the plane is there.
Absolutely, they must know.
And... so that not only do they know the plane's there, like, I think they're using the fact that the plane went down to trying to find the island. So Abaddon's group, I don't know what group he's with, but he's with some, for now, he's with another group. I know you like all these groups.
Yeah, and it's also some sort of, I feel like it's an anti-Dharma group.
Yeah, yeah.
Some opponent.
Yeah, that's a good point. That could very well be. Yep.
I think it was in the next episode. It felt like, hold it. When they see Dharma, they smile because they're on the right track to get that revealed somehow. Yeah. And it felt like everyone is actually trying to do these medicine stuff and all that. And Dharma had this island for itself, and it was a very special island. The other group might even had some spies inside Dharma getting to know, but except for one thing, the location of the island.
Yeah.
There's a lot of stuff that could have happened during the 70s, the 80s, and the 90s.
Yeah, yeah. Now, did we get, remind me if, for some reason I thought I wrote this in my notes, but did we get Charlotte's flashback in this episode?
Yep.
Okay, so Charlotte's the last person.
Yeah.
And... Miles and Daniel and Jack and these people are looking for her.
Yeah.
Locke and so Locke and his group are with wait a second, they're split up right now. So
yeah.
Wait, has that okay, hold on. Miles and Daniel are together with Jack, right?
Yes.
and Frank. So Charlotte's the only one that gets found by Locke then.
Yes.
Okay. So Charlotte's flashback is that she's like an anthropologist or archaeologist in Tunisia.
Yes.
I was cheering. I was cheering.
You were?
Yeah, Tunisia, of Color of Infinity, Star Wars.
There was several references to you, our life.
So do you, so what is she digging up?
She's digging up bones and a skull, and it's actually from a polar bear. It has a collar, and that collar has the Dharma initiatives.
The Hydra specifically.
Specifically the Hydra, that's true.
So how...
She's actually working for that... what do you call him? Abaddon?
Yeah. She... And her face lights up like she was looking for this. She wanted to find this thing.
Yeah.
It's evidence of something. And I can't remember. Did they say the age of the skeleton?
It wasn't back in those days. It wasn't a dinosaur. It
correct.
Wasn't that. If they say something, it's a bit 2.5 million years off or something like that. Yeah. I didn't read. And there was too many numbers at that point. And I was sitting there not liking the lady as well. So I had a bit of a problem with her.
Oh, so I have long thought from the first moment I saw her that this is the grown-up Annie.
Mm-hmm.
Because she has red hair. Purely only because of that reason.
Well, you might be right.
So that's my prediction, that Charlotte is Annie.
Yeah, but Annie, on the other hand, no, she might not even know where the island is. That's true, yeah. Mm,
okay. But she's obviously looking for signs of Dharma.
Yep.
So she, this person, Charlotte, okay. So she is, she parachuted in, present day, she's dangling over a river, she cuts herself. She seems pretty competent.
Yep.
Locke finds her, takes her GPS and sticks it on Vincent.
Yeah.
Vincent
that was a cool one.
Vincent shows up with Jack. Jack immediately knows Locke did it. Okay, so now we have all of our new characters.
Yeah.
So now let's talk about the group. So first off, I wrote down Hugo corrects John on the cabin, but I don't remember what he corrects him about.
Well, the group, the Locke group, is actually moving towards Jacob first.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Hurley says, because, we're not headed towards the barracks. We're headed towards something else.
Yeah, and Ben says, because Locke doesn't know what he's doing, so he needs some directions. That was a nice.
Well, Locke, maybe.
Might be. Ben all over the place, but he's with the Locke's group, and that's really... That's a good thing, I think. I think that's a good thing.
Well, John says that he got his orders from Walt.
Yep.
And nobody really freaks out about that.
Nope. just because they have always considered Locke a crazy person.
Yeah.
And in that case, let me say, when he said that, and he's having these connections with the islands, if he had mentioned... for this group, that he was in a wheelchair on the plane when it went down, they might actually think that, okay, he's not that crazy.
Hmm. Yeah.
But on the other hand, the only witness he has to prove that he was in the wheelchair is Ben. Hmm. And nobody believes Ben.
Yeah, Ben.
It's a bit of a problem. That's the moment. That's a catch 22 if I ever saw one.
Well, so Ben is messing around with Sawyer, trying to confuse him mentally, psych him out. They find Charlotte, and Ben pretty much immediately shoots her. Which makes me think, okay, maybe it's not Annie after all, but I still hold out hope. she has a vest on.
Yep, she has a vest
on. And then we go, and then in this group, It says John is going to shoot Ben.
Yeah.
Oh, Ben says, like, he's got all the answers. He's like, ask me any question you want. And so instead of actually asking questions that will help them, John's first
question is about the monster. Yeah. What is the monster? And I saw Ben just looking at him and said, what?
Yeah, I put that in my notes. Ben's like, what the why would you ask that question? So it just makes me think that John is just not focused on the right things.
No, he's focused on the island. Yeah. That's his main and only concern. He really doesn't want anything else.
Yeah.
But Ben takes this opportunity, of course, to point at the freighter and say that he has a spy on the freighter.
Yeah, that's interesting. And it's obviously not one of the people that came in on the... Well, of course. Probably not one of the people on the helicopter. Mm-hmm. So this is one of the big mysteries of this season. Who's on the who's his man on the boat?
Yep.
And then he says that he knows Charlotte Staples Lewis, which is C.S. Lewis, the author of Alice in Wonderland.
Yep.
and he knows what their primary mission is. They're here for him.
Yep.
So they're not here for the island. They're here for Ben specifically.
Yes, and Miles has also told Jack's group that, the same thing.
Which, I mean, what's your... Do you have any thoughts on that?
Well, first of all, Ben hasn't been on the island all his life. Mm-mm. He's been away doing other stuff. And now he is the ex-Dharma Initiative leader. He's the others. Mm-hmm. The natives and the hostiles, or whatever you call it. But he is the Dharma Initiative's leader on the island. Mm-hmm. And he might have been all in the real world, in the U.S., doing stuff, and they have... Hold it. They need to know that from somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Is it Charlotte anyway? Annie?
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, we don't know. We don't really get any info, but it makes me a little bit nervous that the mythology is now going to expand beyond the island. Like, if they're truly here for Ben, it's because of some manipulation he's done off the island, some competition.
And that is actually making me also that mystic, the magic has gone.
Yeah.
Because Locke is trying to point at the monster and Ben is trying to point at everyone else. And everything points at Ben.
Now,
it's like they can just rename the show to Ben.
Well, and the other thing too is like, okay, Naomi seemed like she was coming for Desmond.
Well...
Or at least she had the photograph somehow, right? So, are they coming? Was she coming for Desmond or for 815 or for Ben? Did they know that all three are on the island together?
Might be together, yes.
So
I think the other group. Now, what do you call him again, that guy?
Oh, Abaddon.
Abaddon. That's a name I'm not going to be. Abe? His group has somehow got in contact with Penny,
mm-hmm.
Widmore, and are perhaps also saying that we are trying to help you find Desmond. And because they have reason to believe that he disappeared in the vicinity of the island, so helping her, or at least pretending to do it, is going to help them get where they want. But she doesn't know, Penny doesn't know anything about any Naomi. Mm-mm. But the Abaddon guy, she might know.
Yeah, I still think it's possible that there's two sets of things going on here and these two timelines are conflicting. That's, I don't know, that's still my feeling. Speaking of Desmond, he doesn't seem to be having any more flash forwards.
Nope.
Which... It's a little bit sad that was just only about Charlie, but Saeed wants to leave the island.
Yep, he's with Jack.
Yep, they see the chopper, and basically the chopper's low on see at this part I guess it makes sense, but the chopper's low on fuel. They can get to the freighter, but they can only take a certain number of people.
Yeah.
So they'll have to go to the freighter, fuel up, and then come back for the rest.
Yeah, something like that.
That's all I have for this one.
Yeah.
Okay.
They also carry Naomi back to the chopper, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they have her body.
Yeah. So, right, so let's move over to the third episode then.
Yep, this is the one that I thought was weird.
Well, I was very disappointed. Okay. The Economist, episode 3. Said and Kate go to the barracks to negotiate a peaceful release of Locke's hostage in exchange for getting off the island. Hmm. In a flash forward, Said's future appears destructive and mysterious. Well, that was a bad one.
Let's do the flash forward first.
Should we do that? Thank you, because that was what really disappointed me.
I remember just being like, what the heck is going on? So basically, Said's a secret agent.
Yep, he's James Bond.
He's working
for Arabic Bond.
He's working for Ben, which...
yeah.
So again, Ben has some things, some missions going on off island, and somehow convinced Said to work for him. Said's not happy about it.
Nope.
But he has a list of people he needs to go around and kill.
Yep.
Now, I think, I don't think this is confirmed, but my guess is that the Economist, the golfer that he kills, is the guy who financed the fake plane or something like that.
It could be, yes.
Yeah. And basically, there's a little love story with Said and this other girl who turns out to be a double agent. I like that part where she turns on him and they fight and stuff, and she was going to kill. She was actually playing him the whole time.
Yep.
I liked that part, but then I didn't like the end where he's working for Ben. And apparently Ben's off the island.
Yep, in this case he was.
So now we have Jack, Kate, Hurley, Said, and Ben off the island.
Well, Ben is not the Oceanic Six.
Well, I don't know, but he's not on the island.
No, I don't think so.
And then we have someone in a coffin.
Yeah, but...
I agree with you, by the way. So some of these people, even though they're off the island, may not be part of the Six.
Oh. What Ben is actually doing, or could be doing, is actually trying to tidy up after himself.
Yeah.
Because what he had done before leaving the island with the others, Jack is going to leave the island later on. He might actually have been paying the other plane and all that stuff. Now he needs to tidy up, because all those guys that knows that Ben is behind it, perhaps they need to be dead.
Well, and we don't know where this occurs. We don't know if this is when Hurley drives the car. We don't know if this is when Jack is crying to Kate. We don't know if it's after that.
But it has something to do about keeping the secret.
Yeah, and it does feel like some time must have passed, because Said is completely in with Ben and doesn't mention anything about going back to the island. He's just doing this thing. This is his new purpose, which, it's just weird, like I said. It was totally unexpected to me.
And because it's Ben who is giving the orders, and Said is one of those who is not with the Ben's group, it felt like, okay, so it doesn't matter if they're on the Locke side, if they're on Jack's side, because sooner or later they're all going to be on Ben's side.
Yeah.
And it feels like, okay, just let's jump up to that point instead, because anything that happens in between will ultimately lead to Said killing people for Ben.
Yeah.
And that really made me really, really disappointed, because anything that happens between this flash forward and backwards back to the island is really not of no importance at all.
Yeah. So
it felt. And that is disappointing, and it's season four.
Well, I mean, they're obviously putting pieces in place for this season four. Honestly, as of this episode, I don't know what's going on.
No, but you said they are trying to make the rest of this show, this series, they have planned season six. They have planned the most of it. Yeah. They know the end. They know all the way back there. We don't. And that's the main problem we have. If we knew just a little bit more, but we don't.
Yeah,
the fun in this episode is actually what's happened on the island.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is interesting too, because this is the one where so I should have said this at the beginning. So season three was getting a lot of critics kind of scrutinizing it.
Yep.
And this season started off. It was planned to have 16 episodes.
Yep.
They made the first eight. And then the Writers Guild went on strike.
Yeah.
And I forget how many, how long it was, but it was quite a long time. Like a lot of shows went on hold.
Oh, yeah. Like a month or so, right?
Oh, even more? More, I think. And then when the show came back, during that time, they basically refined and finalized the whole rest of the show and came back really strong.
Okay, so anything happens up to episode 8 now, I shouldn't be bothered with that much.
I won't say that, but but basically, and they only made 5 more, so this season actually only ended up being,
14, I don't think I have 14.
Yeah, so our podcast is going to be, this season's going to be shorter.
Right, like we are short. Yeah.
And as you know, I've been confused about when the writer's strike happened for so long. But basically, at the point where they came back, in the middle of season four, they had the final script, or they had the script for the final episode.
Okay, so they knew what they were moving towards.
Exactly, and they had to get it approved by the network executives in order to make the rest of the show.
Oh, yeah, because they are always under threat.
Because at this point, if there's a popular show that, you know, back in 2000s, like the network is going to make them keep putting out season after season till they run it into the ground.
Yeah.
And these guys said, no, that's not going to work. Like, this has to be a contained story. It has to have an endpoint. So.
And I think that's what they did right, and that's what I think Games of Thrones might be doing wrong. And I know for a fact that most sitcoms are way too many seasons up.
Well, Game of Thrones has a specific ending, and they've said how many seasons they think it'll take to get there.
They have done the same thing.
Well, that's a different discussion. It's a little more complicated because it's based on a book. But
let's get back to the island, please.
Because okay,
I really liked Sayid in the fast forward was useless. I didn't bother with that. Uh-huh. But Sayid or in the present, that was a cool get. I really liked him. Now, Sayid wants to get off the island.
Mm-hmm.
But he also wants to get on the boat, the ship, the freighter.
Yeah.
And why he specifically wants to get on the freighter, I didn't really get.
I think just to get off the island, right?
You think so?
I think so. I don't know any other reason he would.
Okay. Yeah. Now, he just says, of course, that he can go back and get Charlotte without her being harmed at all. And I really understood from the beginning, as soon as Miles said, I want to go with you, and Sayid didn't say no. Oh, you knew that, Sayid. You knew that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And suddenly I knew how he's going to make Locke release Charlotte.
Oh, I didn't know what he was planning, but yeah.
Oh, it was so nice. And
it
then
was fun.
Then he takes Kate with him.
Yeah, and Miles.
I didn't understand that at all. Why would Kate go?
Because she has to go back to Sawyer, of course.
Why? She already got Jack. She can't have every dad in the show.
Are you really asking me why?
No. Stupid lady is a stupid lady.
Yeah.
Anyway, they went away and they get to the barracks. And because of Locke's being away from other stuff and all that, I really didn't understand how did Locke understand that they will be followed by Said.
Yeah, that was that. I mean, they effectively pulled the wool over my eyes, but it felt like a trick just for the sake of being a trick.
Yeah, but of course, Charlotte is actually one of the hostages. Yes, and perhaps the others, Miles and Dan and Frank, would come to rescue. But why use Hurley? There has to be a reason why they used Hurley. Yes, because it's going to be one of the old beach pop people that comes.
Yeah.
And how the heck Locke could know that? Well, let's say that Jacob or the island told him. Let's just say that.
Or Ben.
Or Ben, yeah. Right. And everybody believes Ben, so that's an easy one.
And Said, so when they're in the barracks, Said actually finds a fake bookcase in Ben's house.
Yep.
And in that fake room back there is all of his passports and identity. So, so yeah, Ben apparently has left the island a lot, even though I had thought that he never left the island, but he apparently has. So anyway, that supports the flashback.
Yeah. And that also makes it thinking about why don't he then go back to the States and get himself the surgery he needed. Mm-hmm. But everything went so fast with that plane crash down and so on. So, okay.
Yeah.
I'll come back to that one as well.
Yeah. So then Said basically trades Miles for Charlotte.
Yep.
And Kate just stays behind on her own, apparently. Or maybe he traded Kate.
No, it was Miles. And the interesting part of this, and we didn't get to see that, is Miles now know that Locke killed Naomi.
Yep.
And now suddenly Miles is with Locke and Ben. Now that could be disastrous even. So they need to put Ben and Miles on ties, both of them. And then we have all the gang over at the temple. What if Richard just suddenly thinks, oh, I've just put down some people to the barracks? I mean, there are several things that are going to happen, but we didn't get to see that. Suddenly, Said comes back with Charlotte, without Miles.
Yeah, and without Kate, yep.
And I was laughing because, yeah. And Frank said that he was cheating.
Yeah.
And Said said, did I?
yeah. So then we see Frank. Oh, and so up to this point, we need to step back a little bit. So in parallel to this, Locke and these guys are trekking through the woods, and he sees like the line of chalk or volcanic. Oh, I bet it's volcanic ash, actually.
I think so, too.
And he sees. Now, it didn't. Did it look like it was disturbed? Or
no, he just felt it because he didn't get the feel.
Okay.
But and the cabin is gone.
Yeah, and this is why I got confused that the cabin was in a different place earlier when Hurley saw it.
Yeah.
Or maybe they just came back here twice, which wouldn't make any sense to me.
No. But it feels like Hurley scared the cabin to go away.
I'm not sure. Yeah, I don't know how to read that yet, but there's some... No, yeah.
Either. But it felt like Hurley saw the cabin, run away, saw it again, but the cabin was just as scared as Hurley. Don't bother with this, but it feels like rather fun. Yeah. So,
And then we also have Daniel doing experiments.
Yes, this was actually interesting.
Yeah. They
31 minutes.
Yeah. So they launch a missile from the ship.
Yep.
Intending to land on the island.
Yep.
According to the ship's radar, I'm going to say whatever monitor they have.
Yeah.
It lands on the island. Everything's good. to the island people, they say it never got here. It's not here. And then 31 minutes later, it lands.
Yes, and it didn't hit the chopper.
So there's definitely some time dilation going on.
Yes.
Now, I'm going to say something that I hope I don't regret later. This made me think of the food drops.
Oh, yeah.
What if the food drops were sent from the 70s and are just now getting to the island?
But that's more than 31 minutes, then.
Sure. But I'm just saying, like, there could be some weird anomaly going.
Absolutely. I'm not saying more against it, because that might actually be true.
Yeah, and maybe they're only still coming because of this whole, like, time anomaly thing. I don't know. It just feels like somehow they purposely want us to know that time is different on the island than off.
Yeah.
This could also be, like I said, there's two different timelines, kind of one.
Yeah.
Like, the island is in a different, moved to a different timeline, so the different freighter. There's something going on here. So, I like this part. This has now gone from a Robinson Crusoe show to a really weird sci-fi show.
Yeah, and that little part that Dan was doing was actually the only thing with the island, except for the cabin was missing. Yeah. And again, it feels like, give me more magic, give me more mystic. This is like, this is more like Indiana Jones than Lost.
Yeah.
And then we have Charlotte, that actually is an Indiana Jones, so why not?
So then we have Juliet and Desmond show up, and Desmond wants to get on the chopper.
Yes.
Oh, because he wants to see who's on this freighter, not Penny's boat. Yep, that makes sense. Yep. So Frank, the pilot, Saeed, Desmond, and the Naomi body get on the chopper and fly off.
And Dan wasn't interested in flying back because he had a lot of stuff to investigate.
Yeah.
And there's no one else there that really needs to go on the chopper at this part. So that was good. And I really liked the part that Naomi was getting back to the freighter.
Yes.
Now, you don't get... That is my main concern. This freighter folk, four people... Three idiots and a pilot, and the pilot we really like. And they are not bad people. They're not villains. They're not a bad army. Mm-mm. To Ben, of course, if they get Ben, they're going to kill him. But that's all there is to it. And Dan is actually more interested in the island than Ben and all that stuff. And because their little army of Naomi is already dead, I don't see them as a threat anymore.
Well... Yeah, I agree. So I'm thinking at this point that this would be a marvelous twist and confirm my theory that when the chopper lands on that freighter, they're going to get off and they're going to meet another version of either Dan, Miles, and or Charlotte still on the freighter.
Oh, dear.
That's just my pure speculation hope. Mm. That would be an awesome twist.
Yeah, and then you would have your timelines. Yeah. Well,
now, okay, let's say that these three scientists. Okay, actually, let's talk about the pilot for a second.
Yeah,
he doesn't feel like the guy that's going to work for the bad guys.
No, exactly. That's one of them. And Miles, because he just gave that old lady $100 back, he doesn't feel like he's going to work for the bad guys.
I think he could be in it for the money.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think the other two are in it for the science.
Yeah, totally.
So if you're an evil military guy on a freighter coming to, or hired to...
Yeah, Goldfinger, you know the drill.
Covert ops this island.
Yeah.
I wouldn't send Naomi first and then send three scientists without any bodyguards.
But I don't think they meant to send Naomi at this. First of all, there wasn't any chopper falling down when Naomi.
No. Didn't it crash in the ocean?
Nope. I doubt that it. You don't have two shoppers on the freighter.
Well, if you have two freighters.
Well, that should be, but then you also have two Naomis.
Oh, yeah, that's what. So they're going to find a live Naomi, and they're going to bring a dead Naomi. Like, that totally feels like where this is going.
Then we're getting the Mystic back.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. That will satisfy me for at least... Yeah. Five more episodes or something like that.
And again, this is a thought that I had the first time I saw the show. I'm having it again. I'm not spoiling anything on purpose.
No.
Or foreshortening. Just saying, this is what, if I was a writer, I think this would be a cool thing to do.
But so. There is one thing that we should probably just say, because we didn't mention it that much in our premonitions before season four. Are we only going to get flash forwards, do you think?
No.
I mean, we have had some flashbacks in episode two.
Yeah, definitely for the new characters, flashbacks. Yeah.
So, well, let me say now, just because I said that I was disappointed, I wasn't enough disappointed.
Good.
Let me say it that way. I wouldn't have... even if I had seen this show by myself and one episode at a time, this is not enough to keep me away from it. I need to see more.
I am hoping... Okay. Oh, I don't want to say this because I don't want to taint it. But I'm pretty sure that there's an episode next week that you're going to like.
Probably. And we're going to see three more, right?
Yeah. Eggtown, The Constant... And the other woman.
All three seems to be nice.
I mean, Eggtown makes me think of smart people, like eggheads.
Oh, okay.
But I don't really know, or it makes
you
me think
you don't have an Eggtown in the States, then?
Oh, I don't know.
We have a pretzel town in Sweden, if that's any similarity.
And then The Constant, I know what that is, so I can't say anything about that one. I don't know. I don't remember what Eggtown is, but I can tell you what I think it is, but I'm not going to.
The other woman, can that be the other Naomi? No.
I think that would be awesome, but I don't have a clue, to be honest.
No, I think there is yet another woman. The freighter is going to show its face, so to speak.
Well, yeah.
Perhaps Annie is on the boat.
I mean, I do hope that this next one, Eggtown, starts with them landing on the freighter.
Yeah, but that's not... Well, it could be.
Oh, no, the other...
Flashbacks.
Okay, the other woman... Oh, man. I just got another crazy theory in my head.
Let's drop that one. I believe we are going to see more of the temple guys.
Well, Oh, that could be. I think the other woman might be related to Ben's man on the boat, which might not be a man, but a woman.
Exactly.
So, that's my crazy theory.
And then we have Mikhail. We never know about him. He perhaps is a transgender guy. He's not dead. He's never going to die. He don't know how to die. That's his main problem.
Yeah.
He don't know how to die.
So I will say that season four, for these three episodes, it didn't start as exciting as I would have liked. It's okay. Nope. There's a lot more new questions.
Well, that's right.
I'm afraid that we're going to go too much off-island, both the flash-forwards and whatever Ben's backstory is.
And perhaps we are going to have big problems making the chronological order in the flash forwards. But if we just try to fix on that secret they can't talk about and the thing that they need to go back, these two things are probably most important.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. The flash forwards and the freighter is the focus of this. And now, of course, I don't remember exactly what happens, but I remember what the focus of season five and season six are now, but I cannot remember how we get from here to there. So pretty excited. Like, there's actually some, I mean, a lot of this show is about the relationships between characters.
Yep.
And there's some relationships that I'm sitting here scratching my head like, how the heck do we get to that point?
Yeah.
So, I'm looking forward to this.
I need more of the character, the island. More the island.
Yeah. The
island, oh, man. The people.
I already have things to say about these next three, but I'm going to wait.
I want to see, watch them first. Well, that is all, I suspect.
I'm good, if you are. And don't look for Lost Via Domus on my channel, but let me know if you, like, are some reason dying to see what happens next.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Let's say goodbye.
Bye.